My name is Carmen.
I'm Ricky.
And of course, you know me, I'm Kenny. And we're about to show you how we're gonna cook some
pinto beans.
Authentic Spanish beans. Mom's pinto beans, that's what we're calling it. Carmen's pinto beans. You're not gonna get any better than this.
All right, Ricky.
Okay, so here we go. Ricky,
we're gonna start off with some bacon that we already chopped and it's already been pre-cooked. We did save the grease to add flavor to the beans.
Okay, and how much is in there, Ricky? How much bacon is in there?
Two slices of chopped bacon.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay.
Ricky, sofrito?
Mom's sofrito, Carmen's sofrito that you can also get on Chef Mobile One's YouTube channel.
Hear that sizzle, woo-hoo!
Oh, the aroma is so rich.
Yep.
Tomato sauce?
How much tomato sauce is that, Ricky?
Half a cup of tomato sauce.
Okay.
Okay.
That's fine, half a cup of tomato sauce.
And just keep on handing me,
one tablespoon of roasted peppers, mm-hmm. chopped.
Okay.
Yes.
And half a teaspoon of
oregano.
Which
you're gonna
flakes.
Go put in your hands, and for the flavor, to enhance the flavor, you're gonna just crush them a little bit in your hands, and then drop them in there, and that will bring out the aroma of the oregano.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
1 teaspoon of adobo.
Adobo.
Comprimiento with pepper.
One sazon.
One package of sazon.
Mm-hmm.
With achote.
Okay, and
then
last but not least, 1 tablespoon of olives.
1 tablespoon of olives with a roasted, with the peppers in it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Sliced and pitted.
Yep, there you go. Don't want to choke nobody.
Yum.
Okay. Maybe now, you do want to choke somebody, but not today, not with the food.
Right.
Okay, I want to make sure that you know that with this sofrito that I'm making over here, you can make any of these beans over here. Ricky, you want to name them?
You can make chickpeas.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let me focus in on that, Ricky, please.
Sure.
All right.
Chickpeas.
Yes.
Black beans.
Yes.
Pinto beans,
which is the ones that I'm making right now.
Which we're making today.
Yes.
Lima beans.
And
green peas. Puerto Ricans call them petit boys.
Okay.
So this recipe here will make half a pound of any of these different beans over here, okay? And right now I'm going to add this to my half a pound of beans. Of course, these are not canned beans. You could, but these are fresh beans that you buy a whole bag, and then you just make half of it.
And I would like to add that the beans were soaked overnight in cold water, and that's part of your prep time. Okay, it's a very simple prep. You know, you open the bag, put in cold water, and leave it out overnight. Okay, don't put it in the refrigerator because it really won't expand the way you know it should.
Now, all you have to do now is that I already had the beans soft already. It's got half a cup of diced potatoes, which is really optional. And now all we have to do is let them boil until the sauce thickens. And we're going to show you that later on how they come out.
Yes.
So once again,
you can make black beans this way. You can make pinto beans this way. You can make lima beans this way. Oh wow, okay.
Okay, make lima beans that way.
And you can use green peas, okay, which is petit pois, okay. And this is what they look like. It's all dry, and you get so much. You'll get so much product out of these dry peas. So it's economical, it's high in fiber, high in protein, you know, the good things that you need in life, okay? Especially when you get into our age.
Fresh, it doesn't get no better than this. Fresh, you know, beans, and they taste so delicious when they are, you know, dry beans,
yep.
Okay? So they're almost ready to be shown, but we'll show you later, you know, the finished
one. And, you know, I want to officially introduce Ricky Morales, which is my protege. He's been cooking for some years now, and I really enjoy Ricky getting into the cooking experience with us. And we're about to embark on an adventure that hopefully you'll see on TV.
Absolutely.
So we're gonna see you in a little while when these beans get done, and we're gonna show you the final product. And we'll taste it in front of you, and you're gonna see from our expression how good it is. All right? So until the beans get done, we're gonna pause.
How long is it gonna take? About 15, 20 minutes?
Another 10 minutes.
Well, you're not gonna see the 15, 20 minutes, but you know, in about 15, 20 minutes, mind you, we already partially cooked the beans for your convenience, but you know, it took about approximately 30 minutes for those beans to get cooked in a pressure cooker. Yes. Okay? Here you go. So we're back.
It's on already. Hi. So we're back again, and here is the final product. We finally, you know, we finished them. They're nice and thick. The way beans should be. Mm. See, and everything good is in there. And now, Erin, you wanna come and try this?
Sure, why not?
Come and try this, and then, you know.
Next volunteer.
He's a friend of ours. His name is Ed.
Hi.
Hi, Eddie. How are you?
Good, thanks.
Great.
Ooh. Of course, this will be taste much better with
it. It smells so great.
Oh, I can only imagine.
These are really the taste. I mean, they go with white rice or with any kind of rice, you know, that you want to, you know, serve them with.
Well, Doña Carmen, se votó.
Gracias.
Gracias.
As they say, you put your foot in it, Mom. So.
Nobody can cook like my mom and my brother.
At this point.
Awesome.
I'm going to go.
I'm not being prejudiced, but these are the best beans ever. My mom cooks the best beans.
Thank you.
And green beans all over the world. I've been to Germany.
Bacon in the throw
it down. Tiene bacon.
Ricky, wasn't there something that you forgot to tell us about with the potatoes?
We did want to tell you that we did cube one potato.
Small potato.
One small potato. About a half a cup to a cup's worth. If you like potatoes, add more. But remember, the more potatoes you add, the more water you're gonna have to add because the potatoes soak up the water.
Okay, so you partially cooked it before you put in the beans?
Yes.
Can you help? Help out our newcomer, Ricky.
Okay, what I did was after I soaked the potatoes, then when the beans are already, you know, soft, then you're gonna add the diced potatoes. You, for this amount, it will be like half a cup of potatoes. Dice, and there you go, that is a piece of potato. You're gonna add it to it, and you're gonna boil it until they get soft. At that point, you're gonna make the sofrito, and then you're gonna add it to the beans, which already have the potatoes.
Okay.
Okay,
so. So let me go ahead and zoom in on this recipe so you guys can get it. And we dubbed this recipe Carmen's Pinto Beans. Okay, I hope this is better than my last video with this recipe here. So you're looking at a half pound of dry pinto beans, two slices of chopped bacon, one
que se merece todo el respeto del mundo, pues canta de lo profundo que existe en su corazón. Es una escuela viviente, orgullo de Puerto Rico, nos cantaba con ahínco junto con Willy Colón.
Oye la murga, qué buena va,
esta es la murga de Panamá.
Carmen and Ricky, it's okay, it's understandable.
I'm not eating yet because I don't want to miss my lipstick, so I eat them later.
Okay, Mom, that's understandable. And Eddie, adios, thank you for tasting the beans for us.
Thanks, great.
And once again,
bye, see you around again.
And you know me, Chef Kenny Mo, you can check me out at Chef Mobile 1 on YouTube.
Bye.
Bye, everybody.
Con su obra musical siguió siendo guapachoso.